The U.S. Army is getting ready to fire all kinds of weapons at prototypes of its new mobile protected firepower vehicle. It's a limited user test, a soldier lethality test, and a soldier assessment designed to see just how survivable this new vehicle will be.
Now, I think they're going to look at the full gamut of what kind of threats we could potentially face near, mid, and far term, and we're going to try to test them in all those environments the best we can.
Right.
Now, the Army has recently awarded a deal to both BAE Systems and General Dynamics Land Systems to build 12 prototypes of the new vehicle, and it's fundamental to the Army's vision for future war. Light infantry, in fact, according to a Congressional Research Service report, lacks the sufficient firepower to go up against light armored vehicles or fortifications, bunkers, various kinds of targets. So they need something that can support infantry on the move, yet also be deployable. Now, Major General Cummings, who's the PEO for Ground Combat Systems, said the vehicle will not be airdroppable, although transportable on a C-17. The idea is not necessarily to seize an airfield or an enemy objective, but rather support once an airfield is secured. Brigadier General Ross Kaufman, who heads what the Army calls a cross-functional team designed to explore the future of these kinds of vehicles, said during the soldier assessments, when they fire weapons at the platforms, they'll also look at whether it could counter enemy helicopters and drones, essentially a short-range air defense. It's not initially thought of as that kind of vehicle, but in a threat environment where the proliferation of drones globally, as well as incoming missiles, longer-range kinds of attacks from potential adversaries, the idea of being able to knock out an air asset from a mechanized armored ground vehicle advancing is considered of great significance.
Helicopter. Could there be a counter drone or kind of counter air dimension to this platform?
There definitely is in the ops command fighting vehicle, and General Kaufman and us, as we go through the soldier vehicle assessment, we'll be looking at those capabilities we may put in mobile protective firepower.
Okay, so Congressional Research Service report mirrors the Army's own internal analysis, which found that necessary firepower with 105 or 120 millimeter cannon, something that's lightweight that can attach to a chassis, they need it to be sufficiently survivable. So if you drop something from the air, it has to be much lighter, which of course would make it more vulnerable to enemy fire. Mobility is key. One of the reasons why the Army worked with Eastern European allies to conduct the cross-European continent Dragoon Ride, to show they could mobilize quickly. The Modern War Institute at West Point raises the point that the Russians and Eastern Europeans have a much more advanced rail system and can rapidly deploy across countries and various strategic areas. So having an ability to move quickly is of paramount concern for the Army as it looks to deter Russia. Of course, the Army has had for years a number of mobile combat systems engineered to support infantry, but none of them appear to fit the particular requirements sought after for mobile protective firepower. If you look at an Abrams tank, 70 tons will have problems with mobility accessing certain areas to support light infantry on the move. Something like mortars are mobile. They're often used in high elevation or various places where an upward trajectory is necessary to attack targets. Those are fixed weapons, however, and don't fire on the move. Something like 777 howitzer artillery is mobile, but it's heavier and can't quite keep pace necessarily with fast advancing light infantry. Thus, the specific push for something like mobile protected firepower.
Yeah. So one of our biggest challenges, both in the cross-functional team and acquisition community, is continue to upgrade our current platforms for anything we may go to war with today. But then at the same time, making sure we're putting our proper investments in future technology and future systems, so the war after we fight after next, we'll have that capability.
The Army is fast-tracking this and expects to have what they call a down select by 2022 and ultimately build as many as 504 mobile protected firepower vehicles. Chris Osborne, Warrior Maven.